year.
Come on, boy. Atta boy.
Skippy the wire-haired terrier is arguably one of the greatest dogs in film history, though hardly anyone knows his name. So thoroughly did Skippy burrow into each role, with such Stanislavskian dedication did he absorb himself in each character, that the audience came to know him only as George, the eccentric bone enthusiast of Bringing Up Baby, Asta, the high-living, crime-solving play dog of The Thin Man and its sequels, and Mr. Smith, the bone of contention in Leo McCarey's screwball masterpiece, The Awful Truth.
Smitty, boy, look up here.
Skippy didn't have his name or names above the title, like Rin Tin Tin, nor did he impress his paw prints into the wet cement outside Grauman's Chinese Theatre, like Uggie from The Artist. But he marked his celluloid territory in other ways.
Smitty, look up here. I win, don't I?
First, he was an eager collaborator. Though Cary Grant resisted appearing with a leopard in Bringing Up Baby, he had no such compunctions about sharing screen time with Skippy. Katharine Hepburn, in contrast, was a born leopard woman, and the trainer remarked that if she ever gave up acting, she'd make a fine animal handler. Grant had already been impressed by the plucky canine's professionalism in The Awful Truth. How do you explain Skippy's screen charisma? He's obviously a natural. Like Grant, he could inhabit a swank penthouse and look at home without losing the common touch. There was nothing snooty about Skippy. He shared with Grant an acrobatic grace and a frank manner. If Rin Tin Tin is the Burt Lancaster of dog actors, and he is, just go with me on this, Skippy may well be Grant's hirsute alter ego. The makers of the Topper series, unable to get Grant to reprise his role in Topper Takes a Trip, engaged Skippy instead. We shouldn't presume that audiences of the day were fooled, but neither did they set fire to the seating in protest. Skippy may have acquired some of his comedy chops from his kennel owner, former silent comedian Gail Henry.
Hiya, fella!
It's not clear whether Leo McCarey's embrace of improvisation on The Awful Truth extended to his work with Skippy. Did the elaborate business with the hats emerge from rehearsal? Dogs like to play and are always in the moment. Or perhaps from McCarey's extensive experience of hat work with Laurel and Hardy. As Skippy sees his character, Mr. Smith is maybe the best dog in America, possibly the world. But still a dog, with a dog's foibles. His tendency to regard everything as a game, and to be helpful when help is not wanted, is the engine driving this bit of bedroom farce. A dog who behaves according to clear principles of playfulness and service makes for a strong comedy foil, if and only if the situation transforms these noble virtues into an unintended problem for someone. In this case, Irene Dunne and Cary Grant. Thus Mr. Smith's innocent goodwill is transfigured into a kind of ironic threat, just as Jackie Coogan can unknowingly endanger Chaplin in The Kid. Director McCarey, a veteran of silent slapstick, is playing his visual comedy in parallel with his verbal, using each edit to unfold a kind of tall tale. Do you believe me so far? He seems to ask. How about now? In a way, Mr. Smith's playfulness clues audiences in on how to respond to this saga of infidelity and divorce. The sophisticated trappings may imply some kind of high-toned romantic drama, but it's all a game to Schmitty.
What's the matter with you, Schmitty?
Mr. Smith was so popular with audiences that he got his own movie 2 years later. But, in one of the tragic injustices of film history, the role this time went to James Stewart.
Come on, let's get out of here.